But already, the Philippine provinces of Nueva Ecija and Cavite are experiencing drought before the expected peak of El Nino. That's according to the State Weather Bureau. And data as of December 17 show 25 other areas have also begun to experience dry spells. According to PAGASA's Chief of Climate Monitoring, Ana Solis, temperatures have been rising in the tropical Pacific for the past 4 weeks, indicating the presence of a strong El Nino. Most climate models suggest conditions will peak at around March or April next year.
Although mataas yung likelihood ng mga climate anomalies gaya ng pagkakaroon ng medyo mas kukunti ang bilang ng bagyo na pumasok sa atin. But then in terms of impact at lalo-lalo na po at different sectors, so yun po ay magkakaiba. So hindi po pare-pareho na magiging impact whether El Nino is stronger or not.
Another Philippine official questions China's sincerity to engage in a dialogue with Manila. Coast Guard spokesperson Commodore Jay Tariela points out Beijing has pinned the blame on the Philippines even before talks can begin. He also criticized China's supposed commitment to regional stability when Chinese vessels use water cannons against Philippine vessels on purely humanitarian missions. Tariela also challenges China's expansive claim in the South China Sea, saying this disregards the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, to which Beijing is a signatory. Over the weekend, maritime affairs expert Jay Batombakal told ANC, engaging China in dialogue is not effective, citing Manila's experience and lack of progress in easing tensions in the waterway.
Beijing is the only one that believes Manila is soaking tensions in the West Philippine Sea. That's according to Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro Jr. Teodoro asserts no country in the world supports China's expansive claims in the South China Sea. He gave those remarks at an event where the Philippine Air Force accepted into service a Japan-built air surveillance radar system.
A lot of countries support our sovereignty and jurisdiction and sovereign rights over the exclusive economic zone and other areas where we have territorial jurisdiction. And no country in the world, none, to this time, has condemned the Philippines in what it's doing. That is the best proof of what I said.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. approves a 5.76 trillion or trillion national budget for 2024. The budget is 9.5% higher year on year. Marcos says the budget is meant to boost the physical and human capital of the nation. He notes it details his administration's battle plan in addressing poverty, health and security, among others. The chief executive also gave his fellow government officials a marching order.
We are working for the people, not for ourselves. We are working for the country, not for ourselves. Honor the taxpayers who make the budget possible. And in doing so, we will bring closer to the brighter tomorrow that we aspire for Bagong Pilipinas that we all envision for our people.
Relatives of Catherine Camilon are still holding out hope they will still find the beauty queen 2 months since she was last seen. We have more from Jeff Caparas.
Rose Camilon appeared at the Batangas City Hall of Justice Tuesday for the preliminary investigation of cases of kidnapping and illegal detention filed against Police Major Alan De Castro, the primary suspect on the disappearance of her youngest daughter, Miss Grand Philippines 2023 candidate, Catherine Camilon. Catherine has been missing for more than 2 months. Rose is still holding out hope Catherine will return home.
Naasa ako. Magulang ako eh. Nanay ako na walang ibang hahangarin para sa mga anak kundi yung kaligtasan eh, yung basta yung gusto ko bumalik siya, ligtas, buhay. Simula pa lamang naman nung umalis siya. Minsan hindi ko iniisip na hindi siya makakabalik sa amin. Wala naman kaming ibang hinihiling kundi yung magkaroon ng linaw. yung malaman namin kung nasaan ang aming anak talaga. Dalawang buwan na rin, hirap. Noon pa, lagi kong sinasabi sa kanya na ibalik niya ang aming anak, ilabas niya kung nasaan. Ang nandun ang galit, hindi mawawala yun. Dahil yung aming anak, wala. Hindi namin alam kung nasaan. Wala namang ibang sinasabi kundi talagang siya ang may alam. Itutuloy namin ito.
Also present in the hearing are two witnesses, Catherine's sister and lawyer of the other accused, DeCastro's driver, Jeffrey Magpantay. DeCastro was a no-show in the preliminary investigation and the complaint was received by his lawyer.
Hindi lang kami nakatanggap ng complaint. As of now, wala pa kami masyadong alam. We'll be filing a counter affidavit after.
The lawyer added, they only received a subpoena and they will need to study the complaint. As for DeCastro, he remained in restrictive custody at Camp Vicente Lim. Camilon was last seen on October 12 in Batangas. The next preliminary investigation is set on January 9, 2024. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.